Good morning everyone. In the previous videos we have understood that power system operation introduction, power system operation and control PSOC introduction, and with and will, what I am teaching, the teacher's point of view, and what I am learning in the student's point of view. Now in this video, let us focus on the first unit, topic 1, that is economic operation of thermal power plants or fuel fired stations, in which the initial topic is cost, incremental cost and heat rate curves. In order to understand the economic operation of thermal plants, first of all, let us understand various curves related to, operating curves related to thermal plant operation. So in the previous videos, you understood that thermal power plant, the coal is burned in order to generate the steam to be admitted through the valve to the turbine. So then turbine will rotate with a specific speed around 3000 rpm, which is horizontally mounted. So then this turbine is coupled to generator. The generator will generate the electrical energy PG out of this steam energy. So therefore injected steam energy leads to generation of electrical power. Therefore the generation of electrical power depends on admitted steam, the amount of steam admitted by burning the coal. So therefore fuel input is coal, which may have some cost, operating cost. So by multiplying that constant with the fuel input, you will get the cost. Therefore C is equal to F into K. F is the fuel input, K is the constant, which we are going to discuss. So therefore the operation of the thermal power plant directly depends on amount of coal or fuel input. Therefore in all fuel fired stations, example thermal power plant, you got the amount of coal to be burned. So whereas in gas power plants, gas is the fuel input. In nuclear power plants, nuclear fuel is the fuel input. Like that, fuel input is used to generate the steam. Then those type of plants are said to be fuel fired stations. Now let us understand various points related to curves. Very first one is cost curve. So this is the input output curve of the typical thermal power plant. This is concave upwards. So this is the concave upwards, which is starting from some initial value PG minimum, is the minimum required active power generation, and PG maximum is the maximum active power generation. So this fuel input is directly related to a generation of the power, electrical power, that is active power, whereas the reactive power can be controlled with the help of excitation system. That was understood in Electrical Machines 3 course. So therefore, you know very well that steam input is directly related to power generation, active power generation. And excitation control is related to reactive power generation. The cost of the power generation is directly depends on fuel input, and hence, the active power generation will involves certain amount of cost. That is the major part of the cost. Whereas excitation system, the losses involved in excitation system are approximately negligible. So therefore, our focus is towards the active power generation and fuel input. Therefore, the curve is drawn between active power generation PG on the x-axis, fuel input or cost of the fuel is on the y-axis, FI or CI is on the y-axis. Actually, CI is equal to K into FI. K may be 1, let us take K is equal to 1, then CI is equal to FI. Therefore, on the x-axis, we will plot the PG, active power generation in megawatts. On the y-axis, FI, fuel input, million kilocalories per hour, or CI, cost, in rupees per hour. Where FI is the input energy rate, million kilocalories per hour, or CI is equal to FI into some constant. Constant is expressed in rupees per million kilocalories. Then CI will get rupees per hour. Rupees per hour. That is the operating cost or fuel cost. Therefore, this is the cost curve, which is concave upwards. The initial point of the cost curve is PG minimum. The maximum point of the cost curve is PG maximum. Why? Generator is having some limitations, PG minimum, PG maximum. We will discuss in this video later. In the meantime, let us understand it is a concave upwards, which is known as cost curve of the thermal power plant or fuel-fired stations, which is the basic and very important fundamental point is the cost curve. Here cost curves, when you consider only one generator, this is the concave upwards cost curve, which is non-linear, of course. If you consider the power plant, so many generating units are there, so which will operate in synchronism. Therefore, in order to operate them in synchronism as a single unit or single plant, you may have number of units. Here let us consider three units, 1, 2, and 3. There are three units are there, all are synchronized. When we are synchronized, we are achieving the synchronism of each of the units, you may have some discontinuities in the cost curves. These discontinuities you can observe here in the cost curve, 1, 2, 3, at 3 points. So let me explain that this is the unit 1, this is unit 2, this is unit 3. All are synchronized and operated. So therefore, because of the synchronization of other units, it leads to discontinuities in the cost curve. and also incremental cost curves, the derivative of C with respect to power generation, DC by DPG is incremental cost IC. So the incremental cost curves are plotted. The power generation is on the x-axis, PG in megawatts. On the y-axis, incremental cost IC. That IC is nothing but DC by DPG. The derivative of cost with respect to the power is the incremental cost. The shape of the IC is as shown in the figure. Here also we will get the discontinuities due to synchronization, one thing. Otherwise, sometimes additional boilers or condenser can be used in order to increase the power generation PG in the same unit. Then also discontinuities will occur. So therefore, all these are the discontinuity causes of the discontinuities in the cost and incremental cost curves. Very first one is synchronization of the units. The second one is additional boilers or steam condensers, or sometimes other equipment to in order to enhance the power generation. Next one, this is the heat rate curve. The heat rate curve is plotted by taking the PG on the x-axis in megawatts, and HI, which is the function of PGI, is on the y-axis, that is the heat rate expressed in million kilocalories per megawatt hour. So therefore, heat rate is nothing but how many calories are required in order to generate a single unit or megawatt hour is the heat rate. So therefore, heat rate is plotted on the y-axis and PG is plotted on the x-axis in megawatts, which gives the heat, typical heat rate curve of the thermal power plant. So which is the shape is not linear, non-linear, and the bottom of the curve, the heat rate is lowest. So the efficiency of the system is expressed as eta is equal to electrical power output by fuel energy input. So electrical power output is in megawatts, fuel input is in million kilocalories. So the efficiency can be expressed in terms of 1 by H. It is inverse of heat rate. Therefore, at the bottom of the heat rate curve, the efficiency is maximum. Efficiency is maximum. At the bottom of the curve. So therefore, the generating unit is most efficient at minimum heat rate. The typical values of the heat rate are eta is equal to 34%, around 2.5 million kilocalories per megawatt hour heat rate. And the fuel input Fi is equal to PJ into HI. PJ is the power generation, HI is the heat rate. So fuel input is equal to heat rate into power generation, PG. That is the equation, expression. Therefore, when you draw the heat rate curve, at the minimum heat rate, the efficiency of the unit is maximum. So therefore, heat, the typical heat rate is expressed HI is equal to A by PGI plus B plus C into PGI, where PGI is the power generation of the ith unit. So in a thermal power plant, so many units are there. Suppose 7 units are there. So each unit will have certain limitations of PGI minimum and PGI maximum. So the generator has to be operated within the limit, within the limits PG minimum and PG maximum. So HI is equal to expressed in terms of PGI, and the unit is million kilocalories per megawatt hour. Then the fuel cost FI is equal to PGI into HI. By multiplying that, FI is equal to A plus B PGI plus C PGI square, million kilocalories per hour. ABC are the constants. Cost of the fuel can be obtained. Ci is equal to K into FI. When K is equal to 1, Ci is equal to FI. When K is equal to some other value, let us multiply K with the FI in order to get the Ci. Cost of the fuel can be obtained very easily. Once you know the cost, incremental cost, ICI is equal to DFI by DPGI or DCI by DPGI. That is equal to approximately, when K is equal to 1, B plus 2C into PGI, that is equal to B plus D PGI rupees per megawatt hour. B and D are the constants, PGI is the power generation of the ith unit. And hence, you can obtain the cost value as well as incremental cost of the thermal units. By obtaining those values, you can plot the cost curves and incremental cost curves as well as heat rate curves. Those curves are very important in determination of cost of the power plant operation. So therefore, it is most important for the optimal operation of power plants, particularly thermal power plants or fuel fired stations. So before going to solve one problem related to heat rate curves, let me explain the capability curve of the synchronous machine and causes of limitations on active power generation as well as reactive power generation. This is the capability curve of the synchronous machine. The x-axis is the active power P in megawatts. Y-axis is reactive power Q in MVAR. So this is the positive side of the x-axis plus megawatt. This is the minus PG minus Q plus Q at the active power and reactive power axis. Here, the generator has to be operated at minimum active power, PG minimum. This is the minimum value. Why it is so? In order to maintain required temperature in the boiler at a minimum value, in order to prevent the slagging of boiler, and hence we need to operate the generator at a minimum active power. So therefore, there is a limitation on active power generation on the lower side, PG minimum. You can say PGI minimum and maximum. Minimum and maximum. So the maximum active power is on the capability curve. So this hatching portion is the limitation on active and reactive powers. So this is the MVA limit. MVA limit is related to, so operating voltage is constant mostly, and hence MVA rating by operating voltage is the current rating, that means armature current rating. So the armature will have limitations, minimum and maximum currents. So the maximum current is IA maximum, which will pose the limitation on MVA, operating MVA. Therefore, that is the armature current related to armature heating. Since IA square RA is the armature loss, which is turned into heat when it is operating continuously, and hence to avoid that heating we need to operate at maximum limitation of the current, IA maximum, corresponding to MVA limit. So this is the armature current limitation, IA maximum. So IA maximum, so that is the MVA limit. So this is on the over excited side, over excitation limit, field limit. This is under excited field limit. So over excited field limit is due to heating of the field winding, due to maximum current, maximum field current, field due to field current loss, field copper loss. So you have some heating. So to avoid that, there is a limit on the excitation, over excitation limitation, under excitation limitation due to end region heating, it is posed. Therefore, under excitation limitation leads to negative side reactive power limit, and over excitation limit is on the positive side reactive power limit. Plus Q means here the generator is supplying the Q to the load. Generator is supplying to the reactive power, supplying reactive power to the load. Minus Q means the generator is consuming the reactive power from the source. During typical conditions, a particular case, sometimes generator has to be operate the over excited, under excited limitation, so that it will consume the reactive power when it is necessary. So we will consider only operation of the generation, that's why this hatched portion. So when you consider the operation of motor, you will consider this side, left side of the capability curve. We are not discussing that now. So this is the capability curve and limitations on the P minimum, P maximum, Q minimum, Q maximum. So this may be Q minimum. So Q minimum and maximum. Q minimum, Q maximum can be obtained from the capability curve. P minimum, P maximum can be obtained from the capability curve. So like that, you have to understand why you are posing the limitations on generation, active power generation as well as reactive power generation. The active power generation is directly related to steam admission into the rotor of turbine rotor, and reactive power generation is directly related to excitation control of the synchronous machine. So let us understand the excitation control of the synchronous machine in order to get Q limitations, so which will be useful in 5th unit, reactive power and voltage control. So this is the synchronous machine. So generator, armature, and connected to the bus bar through a reactance XDRXS, and this is the excitation control of the synchronous machine. So this is the field of the synchronous machine, this is the excitation control. For simple understanding, I am placing some control resistor in order to control IF. But in actual practice, we'll use the AVR, automatic voltage regulator, in order to control the voltage as well as field voltage as well as reactive power. So this is the excitation control. By controlling the excitation, you can have, so this is the lagging mode and this is the leading mode. In this mode, lagging mode, we will have operating voltage V is here. This is the current I. The voltage and current both are related with phase angle phi. This phase angle phi is the cos of the phase angle. Cos phi is the power factor. Here it is lagging. The current is lagging behind the voltage, operating voltage, that is the terminal voltage of the synchronous machine. And phi is the lagging angle. So therefore, the voltage drop in the synchronous machine is Ix. Ix is 90 degrees leading with the current I, and E is the generated voltage of the synchronous machine. Therefore, E is greater than V. And Pg is positive, Qg is also positive. Pg is the active power generation of the synchronous machine, is positive. And Qg is also positive. And delta is the power angle or load angle. This is the angle between the terminal voltage V and generated voltage E, which must be operated within the limitation 0 to 90 degrees. Therefore, it is operating as generator. Whereas in this mode, V and I, current is leading behind the voltage with angle phi, and voltage drop is Ix, which is 90 degrees with the current I, and E is obtained here, generated voltage. This generated voltage is lower than the terminal voltage now, and hence the synchronous machine will generate the active power. Pg is greater than 0, positive, and Qg is negative. Qg is, that means it is consuming the reactive power from the source. So the operating angle of the delta is in between 0 to 90 degrees. This is the power angle. So this is the delta, this is the Pg. So delta maximum, delta is equal to 90 degrees is the limitation on power angle. So therefore, it is operating on the positive direction of the power angle, and hence it is acting as generator, and it is supplying the active power Pg to the system and consuming the reactive power Qg from the system. So this is the typical operation of the synchronous machine. Like that, synchronous machine can be controlled in both excitation control AVR and active power control LFC, load frequency control. So which we are going to discuss in detail in the subsequent chapters. Now let me explain one problem. So this is the problem. The heat rate of the 100 megawatt fuel fired generator is specified. The heat rate H is 10 at 25% rating. H is equal to 9 at 40% rating. H is 8 at 100% rating. It is nothing but the heat rate curve. Pg versus heat rate, HA. But we got only 3 points, which are enough to calculate constants A, B, C. In the equation, H equation, cost equation, we got A, B, C constants. So those constants have to be found from the given data. And the cost of the fuel is K is equal to 2 rupees per million kilocalories. So previously we have taken K is equal to 1 for understanding purpose. Now here K is equal to 2. Then let us find out A. First point, let us find out the cost of the thermal plant in quadratic form. Second one, the heat rate and fuel cost. When the loading is varied with 25%, 50% and 100% ratings. Lastly, point C, the incremental cost in rupees per megawatt hour, IC. So this is the question. From the given question, the rating of the machine is specified. The PG 100% rating is 100 megawatts. 25% means 25 megawatts, 40% means 40, 100 means 100 megawatts. The corresponding H is given, 1, 2, 3. So you have the heat rate expression. Let us use these values in the heat rate expressions in order to calculate the constants A, B, C. After calculating those A, B, C, let us find out A, cost of the power plant, and heat rate and cost when the load is varied, and lastly the incremental cost, IC. This is the solution. HI is expressed as A by PG plus B plus C into PG. So by using this expression, H is given, 10 is given at 25% rating. So therefore PG is equal to 25. Let us substitute it. Equation number 1. Similarly, second equation and third equation. Three equations are obtained from the given data. 10, 9, 8 corresponding to 25%, 40% and 100% loading. 25% means 100 into 0.25, so 25. Like that, by getting three simultaneous equations in terms of H and PG, so we'll solve the three equations in order to get three constant A, B, C. So A is equal to 1000 by 9, B is equal to 40 by 9, C is equal to 2 by 45. So these three values are obtained. By using these three equations, Ci is equal to expression A, PGI, so A plus B into PG plus C into PG square. So by substituting ABC values, Ci is obtained like this. So next one, B, 25% loading, PG is equal to 25, F is equal to 250 million kilocalories per hour. F is obtained by using the expression, F expression. So already we discussed in the equations. C is equal to K into F, 250 into 2, 500 rupees per hour. At 40% rating, PG is equal to 40, F is equal to 360 million kilocalories per hour. In the heat rate expression, this Ci, let us substitute the PG value so that you will get the C value, F value and C value. So C is equal to K into F. Anyhow, F value is obtained from the expression, and C is obtained by multiplying K value. K is equal to 2 rupees per hour is multiplied with F in order to get the total cost. The cost of the plant when 25% loading is taken, it is 500 rupees per hour. 40% rating, you'll get the C is equal to 720 rupees per hour. At 100% rating, F is equal to 1000 million kilocalories per hour. So C is equal to 2 into F, 1000 into 2, 2000. Here, there. Similarly, here F is equal to 360 million kilocalories per hour, C is equal to 2 into 360, 720 rupees per hour. Similarly, at 100% rating, PG is equal to 100, F is equal to 1000, C is equal to 2000 rupees per hour. So like that you have obtained the cost for different operating conditions, and IC is taken as DC by DPJ, that is equal to final expression 8.8 plus 0.17 PG rupees per megawatt hour. So once again, so let us understand this properly. So this is the problem, given problem. The rating of the synchronous machine PG is equal to 100, and this is the heat rate. 1, 2, 3 are the three equations from which you can obtain A, B, C values. So after obtaining A, B, C values, let us find out the C is expressed in terms of H. F is equal to PG into H. C is equal to K into PG into H. Understand? F is equal to PG into H. And C is equal to K into K into F. So these are the equations. H expression is already given. So this is the H expression. Fuel cost, F expression, C expression, K into PGI, HI, incremental cost, IC. Like that, you already understood the expressions. By using 25% loading means 100 into 0.25, 25 megawatts, 50 megawatts, 100 megawatts respectively. Incremental cost is IC, IC is equal to DC by DPGI. So these are the expressions from which you got the ABC values, ABC, and this is the CI expression. By using that expression, let us substitute PG 25, 40 and 100, so that you will get the cost 500, 720 and 2000 rupees per hour respectively for the corresponding loadings. So this is the IC. IC can also be obtained by substituting PG is equal to 25, 40 and 100. You can obtain IC value also. Now in the question, IC value in terms of PG is asked. Therefore, we have obtained the IC expression in terms of PG. So that I'll stop here. So cost and incremental cost curves and heat rate, and why the limitations are posed on the generation, active power generation and reactive power generation from the capability curves, and operating phasor diagrams of the synchronous machine for under-excited and over-excited operations. And one numerical example has taken how to calculate the cost and incremental cost from the heat rate. So once again, let us go through the entire video. So economic operation of thermal power plants, cost, IC and heat rate curves have to be understood. This is the cost curve, concave upwards for the generating plants, which will have minimum PG minimum, PG maximum limitations are there. So these are the cost, incremental cost curves of the thermal power plant, which is comprising of three number of units. Because of the synchronization of units, there are discontinuities in the cost and incremental cost curves. This is the heat rate curve. Heat rate curve is expressed in terms of million kilocalories per megawatt hour. When the heat rate is minimum, the efficiency is maximum. The typical efficiency is 34%, around 2.5 million kilocalories per megawatt hour heat rate. So the heat rate, fuel cost and cost, incremental cost expressions can be obtained in terms of PGI for the ith unit. So this is the capability curve from which you can understand why you have the limitation, why you pose the limitations on active power generation as well as reactive power generation. We need to operate the power plant at minimum and maximum limits on both active and reactive powers. So this is the under-exerted and over-exerted modes of operation of synchronous machine. This is the typical problem from which the generator is operating at 25%, 40%, 100% ratings. So you need to calculate ABC values. After that, let us find out the cost values for 25%, 40% and 100% ratings. The finally incremental cost. So this video focuses on various curves, operating curves of the thermal power plant or fuel fired stations and its significance in optimal operation. Thank you one and all.